The name of the album is finally free. I'm here with Carl Wolf, and you are 8 days out from the album release.
Yep.
And how's it going? How's it selling?
Amazing. It dropped on July 10th, and the first 24, 48 hours was top 10 on iTunes, and we beat out Justin Bieber, of course.
Beat out Justin
Bieber, baby.
There you go.
But you know what? It's all love, and now he beat me again. So
that's okay. On my music, we love Bieber, and we love Carl Wolf.
Thank you. Let's see
if my music fans can put Carl Wolf at the top of our search list.
Oh, that'd be sick.
There you go. A little competition for your fans out there.
Thank you.
So let's talk a little bit about you. This is your fourth album?
Yeah, fourth studio album.
The sound is a little bit different. I listened to it, and it's a little bit different than where you've been before.
Yeah.
Is it an evolution or a departure? You've got dubstep and electronic in there now. Are you leaving your old sound, or is this just part of the evolution of the music?
I don't know. You know, what's my sound? I make music that I love, you know, that I want to hear, ultimately. So instead of listening to someone else, I feel like, you know, I'm in the mood of a electro song or a house track. I feel like going out clubbing or whatever.
Yeah.
I'll make a song, you know, instead of going out listening to someone else's song.
Yeah.
So I think, you know, definitely we got the classic Carl Wolf 80s covers with a dancehall reggae vibe, like Africa and Ghetto Love on the new record. But I'm messing around with some electro house and a little bit of dubstep. I've been hanging out with some people who love dubstep and dubstep DJs. And in clubs and things, and I just like, you know, I have to, you know, innovate as well as a musician, you know, and create something fresh, and not just stay stagnant, you know, especially with my next album. Even as an image, if you notice, the album cover is just a little more, you know, I'm with a tie and a shirt. Mm-hmm. Usually I'm topless or whatever, a shirtless.
I know, we were talking about shirtless, not topless. Often shirtless,
which might happen tonight anyways, but,
you know, I'm sure your fans will be thrilled. The girls are very excited when you arrive.
That's the thing, they love that, but at the same time, you know, I'm like, I'm getting mature, you know what I mean? I'm getting older, let me take my fans, because my fans are growing with me anyways.
Yeah.
So. Let me investigate and experiment with some new sounds and new
looks.
And you
know what? You're going to have no trouble because your sound it's not like a bubblegum sound.
Right, correct.
There's a lot more to it.
That's it.
You should be just fine.
Ethnic stuff. I love messing around with everything in the world. You know, I love bringing it together and fusing music. I think it's really cool when you can bring different cultures together.
Yep.
Like Yalla Habibi that I did. It was number one in Canada. I mean, it's amazing to have an Arabic title go number one.
Yeah.
So there's many, you know, I love making music that people can, you know, think to and also, is not very common.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, you were just last month in Dubai performing with Pitbull.
Yes.
How was the experience for you going back?
Oh, it was amazing. You know, I grew up in Dubai, so my family was there, my parents, some of my friends.
Mm-hmm.
The reason I say some of my friends is because my mom and dad took all the VIP tickets. And they're like, no, that's for me. I'm going to use it for all my friends. Okay, Carl? I'm like, okay, mom. You know, so they enjoyed it more than I did.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it was an amazing experience. Pitbull is awesome. We performed with him before at Summer Jam in Toronto.
Mm-hmm.
So just a good vibe all around.
So you've done some collaborations, and what should we expect in the future? More collaborating?
I think so. You know, I collaborated with 3-6 Mafia on this album, with Juicy J from 3-6 Mafia, Cardinal Official, of course, on Ghetto Love. DeMarco, who's a huge reggae artist in Jamaica, very well respected. And, you know, I'm managing 4 new artists this year as well.
Oh, cool.
So I'm getting into management, Lone Wolf management. We've got Craig Smart, which you guys all know Craig Smart. Lil Jakes, he's a 13-year-old kid artist that stutters when he speaks, but he raps fluently.
Oh, you're kidding.
I'm telling you, I've got an amazing roster of artists this year. So things are looking up.
Very
really
good.
Cool, yeah.
So what should we look forward to this year? Are you doing any really exciting venues that we should look out for?
Oh, yeah. I mean, I'm always traveling. I'm always touring. You can check out my fan page on Facebook, which is facebook.com/Carl Wolf fan page, or hit me up on Twitter. You can check out my tour dates on my website, which is carlwolf.com. My Twitter, of course, is @CarlWolf with an S at the end. We are planning a tour called the Finally Free Tour in October.
Excellent.
It's a cross Canada tour.
Okay.
Which is amazing because I want to finally do my own show. You know, we've done the Headley tour.
Yeah.
I all the way from East Coast to West Coast and back with Headley. But this time around.